long years ago, he lays a tryst with destiny, and now the time comes when we shall redeem our pledge.
On August 15, 1947, India liberated itself from the shackles of British rule. It's a day when we remember the great leaders who shaped our fight for independence. But there were countless other freedom fighters who also shed blood, battled, and sacrificed to make the dream of free India a reality. We bring you the stories of such unsung heroes, the soldiers of freedom.
मेरा केयूर भूषण के नाम से मुझे जानते हैं। मुझे अपने पे महसूस होता है एक गौरव सा कि मैंने स्वतंत्रता संग्राम में बचपन से भाग लिया। और राष्ट्र के अंदर में स्वतंत्रता के बाद भी देश में एकता कायम करने के लिए और राष्ट्रीय जागरण पैदा करने के लिए मैं संघर्ष करता रहा।
Here is a true soldier from Mahatma Gandhi's garrison of 1942 Quit India movement. Meet Keyur Bhushan, a true Gandhian at heart who began chanting patriotic slogans when he was just 12 years old.
उस समय के शिक्षक राष्ट्रीय भावनाओं से उत्प्रेरित थे। जाते ही हमको खादी की टोपी पहना दी गई, बंदे मातरम के गीत गाना शुरू कर दिए, तकलीफ बताना शुरू कर दिए। समय गांव में डिस्ट्रिक्ट काउंसिल वगैरह पे राष्ट्रीय आजादी के आंदोलन के कांग्रेस आज का नहीं उसका वर्चस्व था। अब वो हमको प्रेरित करने लगे, हम वहीं से प्रेरणा पाए और उन्हीं शिक्षकों से प्रेरणा पाए।
Leading several protest rallies against Mahatma Gandhi's arrest in 1942, Keyur gave anti-British speeches and secretly printed and distributed pamphlets to spread Gandhi's message.
हमारी स्कूल की जो प्रधान प्राचार्य थे वो साइकिल स्टेल से आया हुआ पर्चे भेजते थे। वो भले गिरफ्तार नहीं हुए मगर वहाँ से आता था, फिर दूसरे नेताओं के पास आता था, फिर हम लोग वहाँ चला आता था। हम वहाँ पर साइकिल स्टाइल मशीन को पहले जैसे कंडे वगैरह रखने का झुसाव था उसके बाद छिपा के रखते थे, वहाँ से निकाल के हम हाथ से निकालते थे और फिर अपने टोली वालों को देते थे बांटने के लिए।
Even after India gained independence, Keyur continued to serve the nation as a politician and strived hard each day to bring prosperity to his nation. But his heart breaks on seeing the sorry state of political affairs today.
आज के नेताओं यही दिखा देता है, आज कल सड़क में चल रहा था, आज हवाई जहाज में चल रहा है, कल साइकिल में चलता था, वो आज उसके पास कार के नीचे नहीं उतर रहा है।
Not giving up on his dream of a peaceful and developed India, Keyur continues to be devoted towards his nation.
मैं हूँ सुभद्रा खोसला, मेरी उम्र 84 साल है। मैं 13 वर्ष की उम्र में 1942 में जेल गई।
Meet the youngest freedom fighter to be jailed at the age of 30. Subhadra Khosla spent 3 years in jail during the freedom struggle in Lahore in 1942. In awe of the heady spirit of Bhagat Singh and his followers, Subhadra plunged into the do or die movement.
We never saw Bhagat Singh. पर उसकी छाप इतनी थी क्योंकि वो नेशनल कॉलेज में पढ़ते थे और एक दिन में आके 25 किताबें पढ़ते। जो छाप थी उनके सेवा कार्य की या जो अपने साथ मित्रगण लाते थे या सोसाइटी के मेंबर थे वो यही डिस्कस करते, आज़ाद करना है भारत को, उसके लिए जी जान दे देनी है।
While Mahatma Gandhi's Quit India movement created an electrifying stir in the country, freedom fighters like Subhadra Khosla were showing their support to the revolution from behind bars.
हमने क्या किया? हमने चार पाई का झंडा ऊपर इनका उतार के सलामी दे के झंडा अपना लगा दिया. हमारी बहन और दो औरतें कहते इस ये आजादी आप चाहते थे, झंडा तो यही फहरेगा हमारा. तो इट वॉज ए सक्सेस फॉर अस.
Five years after independence, for which so many fought tooth and nail, freedom fighters like Subhadra Khosla still dream of a utopian India.
आज का बच्चा रास्ता ढूंढ रहा है, पर उसको सपोर्ट चाहिए.
I am Krishna Sharma. In the first instance, we had the opportunity to destroy one of the military barracks. Having 16 big houses at Kendugana station. This was the first event in state of Assam in 1942.
Sharma amongst the last of the freedom fighters from a state that is still brewing with violence and riots, Assam. A fighter, a survivor, who started his movement as early as when he was 14 years old, a high school student in Guwahati. Their anti-war campaign coincided with the students' movement and finally culminated into the Quit India days.
We organized students' movement, organized students' union, and started work as volunteers under Gandhiji's campaign at different places. Till 1932, while the Quit India movement was started.
Sharma, a Gandhian, recalled how moderates like him helped hardliners set fire to military camps, sabotage a British bid to build an air force base in Assam, and even derail trains.
There are two groups. One was engaged for purely peace and non-violent method. Others adopted some sabotage activity just to get rid of the military fighters. As I told you, we could come out successful by destroying even military trains. Two military trains were destroyed at our place, which were carrying war materials, petroleum and other materials.
At 90, he attributes the discipline and simplicity in his life to the freedom struggle and his wife, and just hopes to see India shaping up to be the country that many unsung heroes like him had envisioned.
Vande Mataram, Vande Mataram, Vande Mataram.
We risked our lives to see not only change of flag, but social system, economic system, and to develop a sense of patriotism.
These are the patriotic words that N.B. Srihari recalls from his days of the freedom struggle. This 80-year-old decorated soldier participated in the movements against the Britishers as well as the Nizam of Hyderabad.
I, as a student, unable to tolerate the repression that was carried on by Nizam police, I jumped into the freedom struggle.
Keeping their personal interests on the back burner, it is because of selfless soldiers like Srihari that we enjoy the freedom we have today.
I was caught by Portuguese police. I was tortured barbarously. We risked our lives, not for the sake of pension or any other facilities. There was nowhere in my mind that I would get pension, therefore I risked my life.
A follower of Bhagat Singh and Subhash Chandra Bose, this freedom fighter feels that India needs another revolution.
Today India needs not so much of Gandhiji. Today India needs many Subhash Chandra Boses, Bhagat Singhs, so that the spirit of revolt, revolution may revive and save the country. Today we need second freedom struggle.
Stay tuned. On the other side of this break, we bring you more stories of selflessness, valor and sacrifice.